Hello, everybody. Welcome back. Bella here. It's always a pleasure having you around. Today, I'm going to show you. Look at this color. Everything yummilicious. Today, I have my country's flag again on my food. I have some greens, red, yellow. Guys, this palm oil jollof rice was to die for. First things first, guys. I'm gonna need my green veggies. I'm using spinach here. You can use okongobong leaves, ugu leaves, whatever. I need my rice. I need my kanda. I need my tomatoes, blended pepper in there, coarsely blended, obviously. I need my chopped onions, palm oil. I'm using the Meta palm oil. Because I wanna be fancy, I'm gonna use crayfish. I'll use my dry bonga fish or strong kanda, my ginger and garlic powder, and my country onions powder. Because I want, that smoky African-like flavor. So, guys, I'm gonna warm my palm oil. I am not bleaching it. I'm just warming it. Like I want it really hot that when I toss my onions in there, it should make the sizzling noise, like the schwa sound, So I'm using my wooden spoon for this. So the oil is hot, as you can see. So right now I'm just gonna put my onions in there. I'm gonna fry this for like 2 to 3 minutes until the onion is soft or tender. So I really want that aroma to be like all over the house. Okay, right now it's quarantine and I do not have bay leaves at home. If you have bay leaves, you can go ahead and use it. If you do not, that's fine. Just cook it anyways. I'm using my thyme leaves. I forgot to show you this earlier. Put my thyme leaves in there, just a dash of it. And you can put curry powder. I added curry powder later on, just a little bit. So after that is done, I'm gonna put my tomatoes in there and I'll fry it. And I'm now gonna rinse the cup where my tomato, my bell pepper, and my pepper was in there, habanero pepper, like scotch bonnet pepper was in there. I'm gonna fry everything until the oil is like floating, like at the top. I'm just gonna go ahead and keep stirring. Make sure that your food is not burning. I'm gonna cover the pot and then I'm gonna add my Maggi, little bit of salt, and that's my Maggi. I'm gonna put it in there because my Maggi is strong for some weird reason. So because remember I'd rinsed the cup, I just put it in there. It's gonna melt my Maggi, and I just added a little bit of water in there too because I had pre-boiled this kanda and all of that. I am just gonna go ahead and allow it cook very well again with the little water I added in there. I'm adding my garlic and ginger powder, my country onions. Country onions, some people call it ihiro, I think, like that in some places. I'm adding my crayfish and I'm adding my dry fish. I want everything to be cooked. Note that the dry fish, they call it strong kanda, it takes a while to cook. So I had soaked it in water and I deboned I deboned it. So right now the little water I added in there, I want it to, cook up really good, and I want all the seasonings I've put in there, to get into my protein. I'm just adding more water in there because when I add my rice, I just want it to be cooked. Like that's it. I'm not gonna be adding water bit by bit. So this is it. It has come to a boil. And I'm gonna go ahead, guys, right now. Taste it and everything is good. Then I'll add my washed rice in there. That's my chicken bouillon cubes. I just added some in there. So guys, wash your rice, toss it in there, stir it. Make sure that the water is above the rice. For example, if you are using or if you use 2 cups of rice, make sure that you use 4 cups of water for you to be able to cook this, Uncle Ben's rice or parboiled rice. Or if it's basmati, make sure the quantity of the water is half equal. So guys, the water is like dried and all of that. I'm about to take it out in about 2 minutes. So I'm just adding my spinach. You can put scent leaves in here, you can put okongobong leaves, whatever kind of green vegetable you want, but do not put bitter leaf in there. But if you must put bitter leaves, make sure it's a sweet leaf one. So I'm just gonna go ahead, stir. You can use kale and other green veggies, it will still work fine, guys. I'm just gonna stir it. I still want it to maintain that color. Like I said, I'm about to take it out in like a minute. So I'll just stir everything, mix everything, and that's it, guys. Simple as ABC. The jollof rice is ready. This is it. Look at this amazing color, guys. This color is everything. This is our native jollof rice recipe, straight to the point, or you can say banga rice or palm oil rice. Look at it, simple. Look at those colors, guys. This is amazing. If you serve this to your visitors, I'm telling you, they would definitely be coming back. This is quarantine. Do your best to eat healthy. But guess what? I'm African. I'm gonna eat rice whenever. So, guys, without much ado, if you try this recipe, let me know how it went for you.